Good evening, everyone. Welcome to St. Mark the Evangelist Parish. Please join in our opening hymn number 311, Table of Plenty number 311.
Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Oh, come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. I wait to welcome the lost and lonely to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth, come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The Lord be with you.
This
weekend we celebrate the solemnity of Corpus Christi, the most holy body and blood of our Lord. So as we celebrate this Eucharist this afternoon, we all gather acknowledging our sins and we ask for the Lord's mercy. Lord Jesus, you were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen, amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying into the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord, your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers." The word of the Lord.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem, alleluia. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem, alleluia. Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem, praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia. He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat he fills you. He sends forth his command to the earth, swiftly runs his word. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem, alleluia. He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and ordinances to Israel. He has not done this for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them. Alleluia. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Alleluia.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless is not a participation in the blood of Christ. The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I am the living bread that came down from heaven, says the Lord. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your
spirit. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, How can this man give us his flesh to eat? Jesus said to them, Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven. Unless your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
What is that people will say to us when they're trying to convince us why they stopped going to church, why they don't come anymore, why they don't want any part in any of this? What do they say is, well, I don't really get anything out of it. Well, if they don't get anything out of it, I think they're kind of throwing the baby out with the bathwater because they don't understand what it is that we're doing here. What we've been doing as Christian disciples since the days of the apostles, obviously reading scripture, but also breaking the bread. And guess what? Eating the body and blood of Christ. The Eucharist has been central to everything that we do as a church. And Jesus tells us point blank here in the Gospel of John that that is the case. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood will live forever. And of course, anybody listening to him just says, you're crazy. What does that mean? Well, whoever comes and eats my flesh has life in me and I have life in you. We become united when this happens. So it makes me so sad when you hear, well, I just don't get anything out of it because we have the God that we receive each and every week. And if we truly believe that, then how can we not want to be here each and every day and receive him and be united? No matter how far we stray, whatever we do in life, we can come here and be reunited with our God in that great mystery of the Eucharist, where we eat his flesh, drink his blood, and have life in him. And guess what? He promises eternal life. How can we not want that? Now, when we do come here, it doesn't matter if my homily is terrible. It doesn't matter if Artie is off-key. Artie, you sound great. You're not off-key. It doesn't matter if he's off-key. It doesn't matter if Dennis messed up with the reading. None of that matters because we come here, and by the consecration of the priest, we receive Jesus' most holy body and blood. We become united with him when we receive him and we take him out into the world. So liturgy doesn't always have to be perfect, but it is, because we have the centrality of what we do, the central act of our faith, of us receiving his body and blood. We become one with him, and he becomes one in us, and we go out and bring Christ into the world. So hopefully we can always invite people back because they need to go deeper with what this theology is of what church is, what coming to Mass is all about. It's not just, oh, I don't get anything out of it. You receive everything out of it if you understand why it is that we come here. To receive our Lord, yes, in word, but in a very special way, an intimate way, in the sacrament of the Eucharist. So when we go out with joy, spread the good news that if you want to know where God is, he's at One South Road, he's at any Catholic church across the entire world, where we can come and receive his very body and blood, just as he told us, and receive that great gift of eternal life and have life in Jesus Christ. And we stand together as one family in faith, and we profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. In trust and confidence, we bring our prayers and petitions to our loving Father. For the Church, Christ's body on earth, may God strengthen us to joyfully live our faith, bringing glory to our Heavenly Father. We pray to the Lord. For all who hold political or civic authority, may God guide them in protecting and providing for the weak, especially those that have no voice. We pray to the Lord. For broken and wounded families, may the love of Christ bring healing and reconciliation. We pray to the Lord. For our community of faith here at St. Mark's, may the Holy Spirit inspire us in every word and deed. We pray to the Lord. And we pray for those who have died, especially for Harry and Jerry Duffy and William Lambert O'Neill, for whom this Mass is offered, that their souls and all the souls of the faithful departed through the mercy of God rest in peace for eternal life. We pray to the Lord. And we pray for the prayers on our prayer line and for those that we voice in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. We ask all of these things through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please join in our offertory hymn number 325, Eat This Bread, number 325.
Eat this bread, drink this cup, come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup, trust in me and you will not thirst. I am the bread of life, the true bread sent from the Father. Eat this bread, drink this cup, come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup, trust in me and you will not thirst. Your ancestors ate manna in the desert, but this is the bread come down from heaven. Eat this bread, drink this cup, come to me and never be hungry. Eat this bread, drink this cup, trust in me and you will not thirst.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are to be seen in mystery in the offerings we here present. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ. For at the Last Supper with his apostles, establishing for the ages to come the saving memorial of the cross, he offered himself to you as the unblemished lamb, the acceptable gift of perfect praise. Nourishing your faithful by this sacred mystery, you make them holy, so that the human race bounded by one world may be enlightened by one faith and united by one bond of charity. And so we approach the table of this wondrous sacrament, so that bathed in the sweetness of your grace, we may pass over to the heavenly realities here foreshadowed. Therefore, all creatures of heaven and earth sing a new song in adoration, and we, with all of the hosts of angels, cry out, and without end we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present here in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and he breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he himself took bread into his hands. And giving you thanks, he broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving you thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again as we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. And so, Lord, calling us all to your table, confirm us in unity, so that together with Francis, our Pope, Peter, our Bishop, with all of the bishops, priests, deacons, and your entire people, as we walk your ways with faith and hope, we may strive to bring joy and trust into the world. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all of the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever, there in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, with Saint Mark, and with all the saints. We shall praise and exalt you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, 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 amen.
the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us turn to one another and offer the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are they who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 329. I am the bread of life, number 329. I am the bread of life. You who come to me shall not hunger, and who believe in me shall not thirst. No one can come to me unless the Father beckons, and I will raise you up. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. The bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And if you eat of this bread,
You shall live forever. You shall live forever. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up. And I will raise you up on the last day. Unless you eat of the flesh of the Son of Man and drink of his blood and drink of his blood, you shall not have life within you. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. I am the resurrection. I am the life. If you believe in me, even though you die, you shall live forever. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. And I will raise you up, and I will raise you up, and I will raise you up on the last day. How beautiful the hands that served the wine and the bread and the sons of the earth. How beautiful the feet that walked the long dusty roads and the hill to the cross. How beautiful, how beautiful, how beautiful is the body of Christ. How beautiful the heart that bled, that took all my sin and bore it instead. How beautiful the tender eyes that chose to forgive and to never despise. How beautiful, how beautiful, how beautiful is the body of Christ. And as he laid down his life, we offer this sacrifice, that we will live just as he died, willing to pay the price, willing to pay the price.
Let us pray. Grant, O Lord, we pray that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, for which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who lives and reigns forever and ever. A few things before we depart. First of all, I am not here this week, so I told the Daily Mass people, but no Daily Mass this week since I can't bilocate, unfortunately, yet in this career, in my priesthood so far. Check out local area, St. Jude's, St. Thomas Aquinas, St. Matthew's in Wyndham. They'll be having Daily Mass, so Daily Mass people can still go, but I will not be here. I'll see you next weekend. Secondly, the bulletin went out a couple of days ago, and if you read it already, then you know there's some news going on here. Brandon, who is our full-time evangelist, he is still going to be with us. He's not going anywhere, but Brandon is going part-time. He received a full-time job at Trinity High School, which will be beginning in a few short weeks, and he accepted the position to be the director of campus ministry there and also to be a theology teacher. So, number one, pray for those kids, first of all. But it's a great opportunity for professional development for him. He was still going to be with us part-time. If you just see him on the weekend, you're not going to notice a thing. He'll still be with us on the weekends. He's still going to be doing cafe trivia down in the cafe, be up here as much as he can. And also during Lent and Advent, he'll still be running the nighttime faith formation classes once a week. So that none of that is going to change. It's going to be the weekday witness people are the ones that are going to miss him, because he's going to be at school on Thursdays and he won't be here, or he won't be in the office and that type of thing. But if you see him, congratulate him. It's a great thing for him, and I think it's a great thing for our community too, as we get to, you know, kick him out. No, I mean send him off to minister to a greater number of people in the Manchester area. The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May Almighty God bless you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And go forth, the Mass is ended.
Saint
Michael the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And do thou, O Prince of the Heavenly Host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all evil spirits who prowl about the world seeking the ruin of souls. Amen.
Please join in our closing hymn, number 380. Lord, you give the great commission, number 380. Have a wonderful week, everyone, and God bless.
Lord, Lord, you give the great commission, heal the sick and preach the word. Bless the church, neglect its mission, and the gospel go unheard. Help us witness to your purpose with renewed integrity. With the Spirit's gifts empower us for the work of ministry. Lord, you call us to your service. In my name baptize and teach, that the world may trust your promise, life abundant meant for each. Give us all new fervor, draw us closer in community. With the Spirit's gifts empower us for the work of ministry.